All right, hello everyone. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and blargs of all ages. It is time for a very special edition of Grifball on Monday night. I am Goose Cheka, and Receptor is here, but he set too hard to reset his Xbox, and he will be right back to join in the party. So tonight we do have our Xbox One GGL Championship Winter League series, and this particular series is between SH, also known as XRT, versus Girls Love Our Plays. So this is the very last series to be played in the GGL Championship, and well, obviously as the championship in itself, it is the last two teams standing. And I'm pretty sure that these two teams were actually predicted to be here. I think you'd have to go to a couple hubcasts back to be able to know that for sure. But I'm fairly certain. And I don't know whether we're starting or we're just running a host check. Because I know Receptor, I don't think it's in the lobby. So I hope this is just a host check.
They're just starting.
They're just starting?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so no Receptor for this first game?
It's not.
Wonderful. All right, so it looks like we're just going to jump on into it. This game was scheduled to start at 9:30, correct, Cal?
Yep.
Okay, so, you know, we're running on Grifball time. And for Grifball time, we're pretty much on time. All right, so let me just close out some windows. And the controller disconnected. There we go. Okay, make sure myself is muted, which I wasn't. Thanks, Cal. Setting me up for some lulzy setbacks there, and we are underway. Let's see here, we got someone neutral hosting, and opening tip-off. I cannot see who red is, but it looks like they're going for a pro run, and they do. That's Shadow S16, so that is XRT on the court, putting up the first point within just a matter of seconds, and yes, just dominating right out of the gate. Now dropping in behind, it looks like Savasaurus Rex took a hit for him. And now the runner is all alone, completely isolated, having to strafe back just to get out of the range of XRT. So shout out to everybody in the chat box. So glad that you could join us here for this very exciting match. Here come Girls Love Our Play. The runner had an open lane, but decides to drop back. Not trusting his tank, gets popped up and chucks the ball back. Just to be safe, that's Savasaurus Rex, who's going to pick it up. So I would love to hear from the chat box who you think is going to take this first game, who you think is going to take the series. So is it going to be XRT or Girls Love Our Plays or GLOP? So since we're all about the acronyms here. All right, then we got Receptor calling it for XRT. Although I think that would be rather ironic because, you know, Shadow have a championship to his name, and his video will already be out of date, but I guess that's a good problem to have. Holding steady blue now. Again, that's Girls Love Our Plays. Go Glop. Apostle's calling a Glop victory, 6-3. Here comes the runner. He's in a one-on-one. Oh, but he gets hit by Sab. It's okay. He's going to bounce right back, and that is MSSR Martin putting up the first point for Glop. Ricochet. Some lovely red by there. Hopefully that'll clear up. And, Larry, watch out. Here we go. Sorry, Larry. All right, so in our opening tip-off, it is Glop who gets first touch, but the ball is going to take a roll towards XRT. They're going to retrieve it on the plant. Looks like Killers is calling a 7-2 for Glop. All right. Yes, let's just blame Melvin. So anyway, XRT have the ball there on their half of the court, and right now Sab, and that's Infinite Rain, 2v1ing the runner. He gets the ball off in time, chucked to that far corner, and we will see who picks it up for XRT. Runner sticking to that to the far wall, trying to protect himself, trying to help his tank out as well. Someone up there, I think that Shadow's having a good go at it on the tanking front. But it is Martin who splits the defense and forces the runner to drop back. Here comes XRT. But that's even a little too much for them, as they will pretend to pass the ball back, and then I think they just waved at the commentary booth, so saying hello to everybody out there in the chat box land. Oh, I'm sorry. Killers was for XRT. My apologies. Ball's pretty right beneath, and it is Glop who pick it up. That is Savasaurus Rex up top, doing work, gets a trade. Runner has to drop back. That was Infinite Rain. He pitches the ball back to MSSR Martin. And again, I cannot think about MSSR Martin unless I'm thinking about Zero Logic and... Oh, goodness, who was that big feud with? It was Zero Logic and... Oh, come on, Cal, who am I forgetting?
Was it Irish Mafia?
Irish Mafia, that's what it was. That's an old school feud right there, and MSSR Martin is the last of that particular bloodbath between those two teams. On the back, it is Queen of the Sea picking up the ball for Girls Love Our Plays. All three of her tanks surround it. Holding steady on this near side, Martin and Infinite Rain on the tank, and that is Sav on the respawn. Queen just kind of holding back, rocking that Pegacorn, or rather I guess it's called Fotis armor. Definitely a favorite of mine. So despite the quick launch into this game with a 1-1 tie almost right off the bat, things slowing down a little bit, players getting used to the range, the connection, each other, and as usual, things are going to slow down a bit. Although, I think if the ball gets back into the hands of XRT, we're going to see some more ridiculous things. They play a little bit faster paced than Girls Love Our Plays. Not a good thing, not a bad thing, it's just a thing. So Infinite Rain now tanking for his runner who's on the near side, right beneath the announcer's booth. Getting a good look there. Queen gets taken out in the center. Runner has to step up and land the stiff arm. Infinite Rain gets the pickup. And now that's Martin on the far side, so that's got to be Sav who's running. And here they come. Glop just carving through XRT. Runner having to stall a little bit. He's got two tanks on the far side. Shifting. All three tanks are now forward. Queen of the Sea on the inside. Oh! Epic kill by XRT. Just taking out... That is Solace 8 with the lunge and got an assist from a teammate. And even though that Glop play looked promising, XRT just shut it down. So yes, for those who are asking, the Bid League is actually starting on Wednesday. The pro circuit for the Bid League will be starting this Wednesday, as in 2 days from now, and it's going to be a very exciting affair. We've got confirmation from Twitch that the game will be advertised on the front page, and we're also talking with individuals who we know at Rooster Teeth's Achievement Hunter who have expressed interest in also promoting the event. So we're hoping to have a big turnout for that night. And again, we will be having two games on Wednesday Night Grifball, and Receptor will be commentating those. I unfortunately will not be around, and I'm going to be very, very sad that I'll be missing out. But I know Receptor will do a fantastic job, and looking forward to the start of this pro season, as it's taken, seems like it's been a long time in the works. It's happy to see it off the ground. XRT under pressure, have to pass the ball to the far side. Swinging near the announcer's booth, little dodge and weave and happy feet. Get some room to run in his center tank. I think that is Shadow just stepping up, and I might have gotten a bit of a love tap, but you know that's how the cookie crumbles. Runner steps up, kills Sab, and did a little swinging motion there. I think that's Net's Pride who is running for XRT. XRT still with possession under pressure. Net's Pride checks the ball across the court. Still in possession. XRT doing very well, holding on. And again, they have a solid press going forward, but Martin shuts down one tank. Sab steps up. Now Infinite Rain. Infinite Rain betrays Sab, but is holding the line. Someone on the... I can't even talk. It's so exciting! Ragemore Nerd is on a killing spree, and he allows Shadow S16 to walk it on home. So right now, we are up 2-1 for XRT. This is game one of a three-game series. So if you are new to professional Grifball, as we like to call it, we play all 9 rounds of Grifball awesomeness, and it is a best-of-three series. So we will see who wins this game, and then we'll go into game two. And obviously, if we've got two winners, then it will be done and done, and we will crown our new champions, or we might be pushing it to game three if the series is split. So lots of Grifball to play here tonight. And what an exciting week for Grifball streaming. You know, tonight we have the Xbox One the Xbox One GGL Winter Season Championship. And then in about 48 hours or less, we're going to have the kickoff for the AGLA Pro Circuit season. And on Thursday, we're streaming as well. So we have a ton of Grifball action in store for you this week. And like I mentioned, Receptor will be commentating on Wednesday night. And then you will get the pleasure of the dulcet tones of DJ Blue for your Thursday night Grifball hookup. XRT are holding possession just about the midcourt. MSS R. Martin is trying to corral the runner who's strafing to the near side. He's got someone on that back post, runs, jumps, decides to pass back instead. Fall a little bit off target, but a run on to pick up. Ragemore Nerd is on another killing spree, and here comes XRT just crashing the gates. There was nothing doing there for Girls Love Our Play. That's XRT up 3-1. Alright, Fisk has a prediction for the scores. Love to hear predictions from the chat box. As always, chat box, if you have any questions, if you're not familiar with the term, or if you're new to the Grifball community, please feel free to post in the chat box. We're all a very kind, loving, sometimes a little bit too touchy-feely bunch. So we really appreciate everybody coming out, supporting these teams, whether you're a Grifball veteran or you're a total noob, you are totally welcome here in our Grifball chats. We're happy to have you. So Killer's expressing his love for Rage, and seriously, who doesn't? You know, who doesn't like a guy who can bring you pizza? It's pretty much fantastic. Here comes Girls Love Our Place. Oh, gets popped up at just the last second. Airborne, can he stick the landing? No. Solace 8 credited with the kill on MSSR Martin. Huge stop by XRT. Coming up big when it's needed. All right, so we've got Fist calling for XRT to take game 1, 5-2. Game 2, 4-5 in favor of Glop, and then game 3 going to XRT. So Fist calling it a 3-game series with XRT coming out on top. Coming on the underside, we've got Glop. Girls Love Our Play. Sab sword tanking, switches back to the hammer. Runner has shifted to the far side. A little bit of confusion here for the Glop players, but they've reestablished themselves, given Martin the ball. Martin steps up, gets the stiff arm. But unfortunately, he just can't punch all of them in the face. He can punch a lot, maybe not all. Girls Love Our Play is now on the far side. Sab tanking. Here comes Queen of the Sea as she steps into the center. Gets a solid kill. Runner spreading the court, trying to create some space. Here comes Infinite Rain. So a good series of kills by Girls Love Our Play, but just gets shut down. Sab is high on the far side, but the runner's going to have to drop back under some pressure, and Sav gets taken out. Glop still with possession. Readjusting. Some pretty good spacing by Glop. Close, but not so much that they're going to murder each other. That's always a fine line to walk, and again, they're just looking to try and get a string of kills together. They're up against a very difficult XRT team with a lot of very experienced players on both rosters, although I would say that Girls Love Our Place have a bit of a less experienced team, not inexperienced, but for example, Queen of the Sea is a relative newcomer to the Grifball world, especially if you compare her to someone like Martin or Shadow or even Net on XRT. So a lot of grizzled veterans on the court tonight. And of course, it's got to spice it up with a little bit of new blood, too. It's the way we like it. Under pressure, Glop shifting to the near corner. Sab gets the ball off just in time. Looks like it's going to go to Martin. Picks up the ball, but is instantly under pressure, has to cross his own plant under duress. Sav, last man standing, is able to buy his runner some time, who goes to about half court, and again, is just trying to find space, give his tank some time to reset and spawn and get a move on. But again, wasting no time, pressing forward, trying to be as aggressive as he dares. He's in behind. That's Queen of the Sea. And now Infinite Rain steps up as well. Queen gets a solid kill. She's clearing out this near lane, although the runner has shifted to the far side. Queen trying to hold off this right flank, but eventually gets taken out. 3-on-1 is always a difficult position to find yourself in. Once again, the runner trying to stretch the field, putting themselves in danger's way, as that's two stiff arms. Martin delivering two stiff arms to drive home the goal. So 3-2, XRT currently leading Girls Love Our Plays in this first game of the GGL Xbox One Winter Series Championship. So it's always nice to have a good and, not even just good, but a close match. Always makes for a fun time here in the commentary booth. As the ball rolls to me, hello little ball. And then as Queen of the Sea picks it up, chucks it back into Martin's capable hands. Sav now standing vigilant over his runner, trying to protect him, just trying to buy time at the last point. Here comes XRT, snipes the runner right above the plant. Ball drops, and somehow Girls Love Our Play come up with that. Not out of the woods yet. Under pressure, Sav has to chuck it backwards into Martin's hands. And a huge sigh of anxiety and relief by Girls Love Our Plays. What a dangerous position they found themselves in. And it has not gotten any better. They're forced to pass the ball all the way back to their Halo just to get a modicum of breathing room. Now they're going to try their luck on the far side. Their three tanks forming a defensive pattern around the runner, who again is staying behind there pretty safely. And it's going to be in a lot of trouble. Got two tanks in front, but two enemy tanks behind. Sav does a stutter step, gets the ball off to Martin. Martin center runs steps, gets the stiff. Thinks about a stiff number two, holds off. Infinite rain hoofs as lead tank gets taken out. Sav stepping up, gets a trade, but it'll just not going forward, but at least gave his runner some time to escape. So turnover right here in front of the announcer's booth, and everybody's just dead. It was just an explosion of bodies, but Girls Love Our Plays recover and are instantly under pressure. Martin gets the ball off just in time. That is Infinite Rain who's going to pick it up. Three members of XRT just crushing down that far corner, trying to corral all the members of GLOP into a tight spot. But here comes the runner once again, using his body as a bait to try and create some space and some room, get XRT to maybe bite one way and then zigzag back the other. And of course, Grifball is still a thing. We've always been a thing. We don't believe in any of that we back, because we've been here. Girls Love Our Play, still holding possession. They're only down by 1 point so far in the series. Under a lot of pressure. Oh! Almost intercepted. But it is Martin who will come up with it. He's under pressure from two XRT players. They're just kind of swarming like piranhas in a gooey, gory blood of... That's kind of gross. Never mind. We're going to go back to Girls Love Our Plays as they are making their way down the court. Runner hanging tight with Infinite Rain, who's doing a very good job of patiently just kind of holding steady there at that... about the 18-yard line, and a huge trade saves the runner from an epic lunge. And Cal is laughing hysterically. I don't know why, because I can't read the chat box and stream at the same time. Maybe if I grew another pair of eyes, it would be easier. Cal, do you want to share your giggles?
Crowbar.
What is Crowbar saying?
Would have gotten away with the 2-14 medal
again. Ah, yes. You know, it happens. It happens. Yeah, AGLA 2008, represent. Kicking it old school with us geezers. Girls Love Our Play, still on the offensive. XRT applying a large amount of pressure. And Girls Love Our Play really haven't had much of a chance this round to make it even past that halfway line. Having to track all the way back once again, drop in behind the spawning tanks. XRT controlling the spawn points. So you have someone who's... Oh, epic lunge! Nets probably get the kill on the runner, and they force a turnover. Infinite Rain is in pursuit, but that's going to be XRT ball. XRT looking to increase their league and bring themselves one step closer, just like Legends of the Hidden Temple. Step down, step one step closer to, well, running through the Hidden Temple. But instead of a Hidden Temple, we have a Grifball Court. But there are no Temple Guards, so do not worry. Ragemore Nerd gets in a pretty difficult spot, but a beautiful pass to the far side, and XRT is going to keep possession, keeping it secret, keeping it safe, and now are on the counterattack, three tanks forward, possibly a betrayal there, I'm not quite sure, But now they're down to one tank, and the runner staying high as much as he can across that half-court line, trying to give up as little as possible in terms of space on the court. Yep, huge shout-out to Corey. He was quite the figurehead staple in the old AGLA 08 days. I know I've seen his lovely text around the forums. Always good to have the old-school veterans back. Makes it a lot more fun when you say stuff like, back in my day, and people actually know what you're talking about. XRT still holding steady. They're coming on a cut from the right side. The near side, looking good. It's a 2v3, and it is the defensive play by Girls Love Our Plays, who steps up and carves out a space to get a little bit more room, forces the runner back to the halfway line, but not for long, because the runner is once again just knocking at the door. Three tanks forward, runner almost fancied a stiff arm against Infinite Rain. Infinite Rain made him pay, but here comes more tanks who just, I think, appeared out of nowhere. And unfortunately for XRT, they're just kind of chuck that back. A toss-up ball, and it is Infinite Rain who comes up with that. That was a rugby scrum waiting to happen, but Infinite Rain just greased up, slipped right on in, and managed to pull the ball back for Girls Love Our Plays. Shotgun launch attempt, and what a beautiful shotgun it was. Runners run away, gets bounced up. Oh, gets a second stiff arm. Ragemore Nerd coming up with the kill. A beautiful attempt by Girls Love Our Plays, and but an epic defensive triumph by XRT. Getting that, even though didn't get the kill, pops the runner up just enough. You want to talk about classic Summer League 08 style? There you go, popping the runner up, even if you can't get the kill, so that your following teammates can crack down and let that thing happen, because that was some fantastic running by Girls Love Our Plays. Got that double stiff arm, and so just some great Grifball all around. So XRT, recouping, settling down. Runner isolated on the far side, wastes no time, pitches the ball back. Trying their luck on the far side. That is Queen of the Sea doing some work at the midcourt line, but is taken out by Solace 8. And here comes XRT getting a lunge forward with the runner, soaring through the air matchmaking style. And it was a diversion, it was a trap. And Girls Love Our Plays sussed that out pretty quickly. But here comes XRT, they've got two tanks, everybody else is on the respawn. Queen of the Sea with a clutch kill. She comes in and chops off the attack route for the runner. And she gets that epic lunge with the sword. As you can see, swords and bodies and hammers just strewn everywhere here on the Grifball court. That's just the way we like it. XRC holding steady on their own spawn line. Chucks the ball to the far side. Under pressure from Queen of the Sea, but she's taken out. Shadow S16 gets a double. Triple. Kill tack. And that is a huge opening, and you know, when you go with getting a kill tap and your runner's right there, there's no coming back from that. So XRT goes up 4-2 over Girls Love Our Plays. So sudden death for GLOP. One more goal for XRT, and that will be game one. Regardless, we will play all 9 rounds, because that's how we do. New ball spawned. Alright, it's okay, Banjo, you can mute me. Just makes me cry on the inside at night. That's okay. They're just feelings. Girls Love Our Plays. The runner for them lands a stiff arm. Let's see who is that. That is... I can't tell because too many people are dying just way too fast. Here comes GLOP. They see... have an opportunity. Runner trying to find a seam. Sab, unfortunately, cannot bring it home. Infinite Rain falls. Queen of the Sea steps up. And they are on their heels, trying to repel the onslaught of XRT. It's okay, Banjo. Like I said, they're just feelings. Girls love our plays. Runner, dangerous game played there. Stepped up, got the stiff arm, but had absolutely no support. Runs back, gets a second stiff arm. That is Martin. He's on a killing spree, and he's also the bomb carrier, so that's telling you how his night is going. No fear of that, boy. The ball in his hands, and you got yourself a tank. And here they come crashing down. Martin steps up, oh, but Ness Pry says, oh, no, no, and rejects the advance. XRT was positioned at about the halfway court. Where did... There we go. Paul disappeared real briefly. Yeah. But it is back in XRT's possession. And they're tanking down that far side. They have a ton of room to run. That's Infinite Rain having to sprint all the way cross-court just to give his team some support. And of course, he is rewarded with a double kill, which puts him on a killing spree. Yes, I'm glad my guild trip worked. You're welcome, Banjo. XRT on the near side. Infinite Rain tracing. Runner now strafing far side, trying to get a different angle. XRT liking the situation. He's in a one-on-one on the plant. He's got someone right behind him. Oh, don't jump! What? I don't even know what just happened. It's like he ran up to the halo and hit a wall instead of a hologram. So that was Infinite Rain. Shadow is on the re-up, but Infinite Rain struck him down. And here comes Girls Love Our Plays trying to capitalize on a counterattack, but are driven back. That's Martin who had to land a stiff arm on Rageborn Nerd in order to allow his tank some time to actually, you know, spawn. Girls Love Our Plays threatening once again. Martin standing tall, but Solace finally takes him down. XRT with possession. They've definitely had the short end of the stick in terms of possession, but have done well with maintaining it. And obviously they've got 4 points on the board, so they're doing something right. Everybody's dead, so the runner has to drop back. Again, XRT in red, having possession. Infinite Rain cuts off any kind of escape route from the runner, so forces him to the near side. Sab now trying to corral the runner, who gets the ball away quickly, gets a trade, and the ball is now in the... Since I can't see the call signs for XRT, I actually can't make out who is running. But Shadow 16 is tearing things up in the spawn, and the ball just kind of exploded, but now it's in the hands of Infinite Rain. So another turnover in this pretty fast-paced and game. A lot of turnovers, I loved the shotgun launch that Girls Love Our Plays pulled off. It was so close to just being an epic championship highlight. I love seeing that ingenuity and that creativity on the court. Again, Martin just beasting it with the ball in his hands. I don't think anybody has told him. I'm sorry, that was Infinite Rain. My apologies. Infinite Rain now on a killing spree, refusing to leave the campsite of XRT spawn. I'm gonna guess that's that was Martin, who, like I was mentioning earlier, I don't think anybody told him that he was a runner and not necessarily supposed to charge brazenly into battle, because he does anyway. Although, there is a new runner now. Again, Infinite Rain passes the ball back to Martin, and those two seem to be changing up the ball quite a bit, and neither of them are shy when it comes to stepping up with a stiff arm. So yeah, spectator mode for Halo 5? That would be awesome. Cal, are you making people spell your name?
No.
Good. So Girls Love Our Play is giving a lot of room. The runner dropping way back. And that is Martin. So I'm not gonna try and... No judgment here, Martin, but gave up a lot of space there. And now there's a member of XRT chasing Martin on his 6. He's got 2 tanks charging forward. And now Martin's in a lot of trouble. He punts the ball out. Sav, who is instantly under pressure. Infinite Rain steps up, holds off the enemy long enough, and now the ball's shifting to the far side, back into the hands of Martin. Another punch to the face, and Girls Love Our Play are hacking their way forward. They've got XRT on the spawn. And can the runner sneak it in? Looks like it should be wide open. There he goes, taking it home. That's Martin putting up the third point. the bringing it home, the bacon, so to speak, for Girls Love Our Plays. He's got all 3 points for them. I know Piggies brings home the bacon, gal. Thank you. And I think it's just about the right time. I might be about 15 minutes early, but huge happy birthday shout out to Receptor 17, who should be able to get into the next game for some additional commentary with me. He turns 24 years young. So happy birthday, our Welsh friend. I hope you enjoy it. And eat lots of cake and beer. Not necessarily in that order, though. Some action right beneath our feet here as Girls Love Our Play carve out some space. Sab and Infinite Rain, and there, here comes Queen of the Sea. So we've got Martin running. He's staying high and tight. He runs up, gets that one-on-one. Fancy's another one, but it gets the members of XRT really close together. Sab was so close to that double kill. Didn't quite pan out this time, but a very aggressive strategy being used by the runners for Girls Love Our Plays. And, you know, they've got to step it up right now. They're down. It is only game one, and so all is not lost, but it's always good to go into game two up. A morale booster. And Nets Pride is doing work, gets a kill on the carrier. Ball's free, and Infinite Rain is there. Oh, but gets taken out. Shadow S16 on a killing spree. I believe that's him in the spawn, just tearing it up. Look at him go, ladies and gents. Finally taken out by Queen of the Sea, but is it too late? No, X, whoa, what a lunge by Queen of the Sea. She kind of surfed that one in. Runner was wise enough to get the ball off just in time, and my heart goes out to Shadow there. There's nothing more frustrating than when you're in there, you're in the zone, you're killing everything, and it's just not enough. So, Cal, guess what? Do you know what XRT stands for?
Yes, I do. As long as there are no follow-up questions, I do.
Well, it's just a dyslexic RTX.
Thank you.
All I'm saying. Ball crossed court, still in possession of XRT, your red team on the screen. This is still game one of the series. Again, this is the best of 3 series, so we'll see if we'll need 3 games or not. And this is the championship for the GGL Pro, for the GGL Xbox One Winter League Circuit. The ball randomly appears in Savasaurus Rex's hand. Not gonna say he had hacks, but it kind of looked like it. So Girls Love Our Plays have reclaimed the ball, and a lot of passing back and forth, stretching the field, making XRT run side to side, and hopefully try and create some passing lanes and maybe even some mistakes. Runner right below steps up, gets with stiff arm on the sword, but did not necessarily see the enemy tank right behind him. XRT almost causing another turnover, but somehow Girls Love Our Plays. They're hanging in there. They're refusing to, they're never going to give up. They're never going to let you down. And they're going to chuck the ball. Oh, it got deflected straight up in the air. Free ball, XRT trying to crash on that. It's taking a roll towards Girls Love Our Play. XRT get the ball and somehow managed to kick it across the court. That was quite the impressive throw, especially considering the player was moving backwards as he passed, which is an accomplishment. I've got to maybe ask him how he did that, because that never works for me. But here comes XRT. They got someone on the plant trying to put up shop. Runner standing there in the wings of the 2-on-1 on the plant. Runner holding steady. Still got 2 tanks there. Queen of the Sea is not enough. And that's Shadow 16 parting the Queen of the Sea and driving home the 5th winning point of this first round. So game one officially goes to Xbox Record that. We will play this final round because it's fun and we like to. But then we'll be moving into game two almost immediately following this one after we allow everybody to have a water break, stretch break, potty break, all the breaks, beer break, whatever you want to call it. So thank you all for tuning in to this lovely Monday night edition of our live stream Grifball. beautiful pop-up by Girls Love Our Plays. They pass the ball back down, just a little bit off kilter. And some confusion. Martin looks like he lost track of the ball, and now the ball's just... There we go. It's on the far side. Sometimes disappears from your screen. XRT gets a bump, and a solid kill by Queen of the Sea. Runner steps up, gets slayed by Martin. Martin goes down as well, just a scrum in that far corner. Queen of the Sea has the ball. She is not able to get the ball off. The ball's over there, and now XRT has it. Runner steps up, gets one stiff arm, goes for the wall hop. Unnecessary wall hop is unnecessary, and gets bounced out, and somehow lives like a pinball just bouncing off that backboard. That was Shadow S16 going for the glory, and Martin shutting him down. So Girls Love Our Plays. They may have lost this first match, but they're still going for the glory. Those points can matter. Runner steps up, lands a stiff arm. He's got infinite range in the spawn. Queen of the Sea stepping up. She's in a 2-on-1. Runner steps up, gets one. Oh, tagged at the very last second as he got the killing spree taken down by XRT. Shotgun lunch by XRT, and it is busted up instantly by Queen of the Sea. And that was totally fine. That was awesome. Girls Love Our Plays looking to finish out the game strong. Infinite Rain tanking in. Runner staying high and tight. Here comes Queen of the Sea trying to help out a runner. She gets one. She gets two. Opens it up. And Martin will drive home the fourth point. So what a great match for our first in the series of this Xbox One GGL Winter League Championship games. We're going to break down the stats for you real quick. Check in with the teams. We're going to try and pull Receptor in here so that we can have two commentators, which is always better than one. And then we'll be rolling right into game two. So huge shout out. While the stats load, I just want to shout out to everybody who's in the chat box. So Crowbar, Melvin, Mr. Fluffy, Ulift, Shadow, Unknown Names, The Raider, Sapsief, Killers, Alpha, Turtle, Alpha, Biggies, Kev, Queen, Munchkin, Sir Gaming Fan, Cannon, Receptor, Godless, 4, Yeezus, Raging Fury, Rage, of course, Grunt Padre, Fisk, Ogloff, J-Bar, Apoc, Digital, Pack, Banjo, Noplex, and Angelus? And Angelus. So thank you all for coming out tonight, and be sure to stay tuned for our next round. So your stats breakdown. XRT was led by Rage Mornard with 2,365. Shadow at 2,225. Nets Pride, 2,170. And Solace at 1,860. For Girls Love Our Plays, Martin was at 2,650. Infinite Rain, 2,600 even. Queen of the Sea, 2,200 even. And Sab at 1,965. So very even in terms of score. Let's take a look here. So again, Shadow scoring 4 out of the 5 goals for XRT, and Martin scoring 4 goals for Girls Love Our Plays. See some defensive stops there. 3 for Solace, so he definitely came up huge for XRT in the defensive arena. There was 1 interception, and that also came from Solace. So I think if Defender was still a position, he would definitely be getting the defensive MVP. This was a 32-minute game, so almost like right on par for an average Grifball match. Rage War Nerd was positive 11, Shadow negative 32, Nets negative 26, and Solace negative 19. Martin went positive 14, Infinite Rain positive 35, a beast. Queen of the Sea negative 9, and Sab negative 7. So some interesting KD spreads there. And I want to see what his medals look like. Yeah, look at that. Killtrocity. Yeah. He had 5 killing sprees. That is crazy. All right. So, again, we're going to try and get Receptor in here. I'm going to hand this off to Cal because I don't like to touch the Master Chief Collection because it hates me. And we're going to try and get Receptor in here and just roll right into round 2. So if you need a quick break, this is the time to do it. We're back with round 2. If you are just joining us and you missed the first game, this is game 2 of the Xbox One GGL Winter League Championship Series. So we're going into game 2. Game 1 went to XRT 5-4, 5-3 for those who like to count it that way. And for our second act, we are bringing in the one and only and oh-so-talented and oh-so-birthday boy, Receptor 17.
Thank you very much, Goose. And I'll be commenting for Red Team. I believe that is Xbox Record that. Am I correct?
Yes, and so am I. So...
Well, this is going to be an interesting match, but yeah, so at the moment it is Girls Love Our Plays currently with the ball. Just trying to figure out who that is at the moment with the air assault helmet just going underneath. I believe that is Meza Martinez. He's got one tank just protecting him and just inside. But Xbox record that just come along and wipe it out. And somehow my Xbox didn't listen to me when I said that. Thank the Lord. But Glop once again just rests the ball from the runner's dead hands on their end of the court. Trying to just hug against that wall. Trying to cut down any kind of attacks from the players. So it's got one less attack to go through. Gets the stiff arm. Tanks come in to protect. The ball's going to be thrown back. Arcs across the sky and is caught. So let's see, Troika, I think it's Meza Martin once again who has the ball. As they're just setting up, we have XRT just trying to forge their way around, making that defensive wall, trying to bait the runner towards them so he can just rest it away. But at the moment, it's still Girls Love Our Plays who have the ball up on the opposite end of the court from where we are in the commentary booth. But once again, all pressure against them as they're dealing with it. As jumps over his own plant with swords behind, we're still there, but Sav keeps just there, gets the one slice down, and he's going to get the second one. No, he's taken out. But once again, the runner is still there, alive somehow, despite the attempts from XRT trying to get close to it. But it's just not going to plan at the moment, but slowly advancing. Once again, Sav just gets the kills, which, yeah, Savasaurus Rex, my apologies, calling him Savkeep to start with, so my apologies, Sav, as he's really clearing up M37, which is Meza Martin. I've been looking at all the wrong rosters, Goose. It's a good start for today. But once again, it's... So it could be Shadow actually who's on the ball at the moment, because it's very the same with two commentators at the same one, but we'll work our way around it. But once again, it's just trying to find the way forward. One sword time just sneaking underneath. That was 365, which is infinite rain, but it wasn't enough. Couldn't find a way as the hammer tank just came in just to deny any chance of a lunge. As once again, Girls Love Our Place just holding steady. The three tank posts is just forming up now. Two forming up together, and mind that clumping. As you got one flanking in from the side. Could that be a decisive play where they come and arc in from the side? No, it's not enough. Xbox recorded that and somehow managed to get the way around it. And get it. Oh, and a massive lunge there from one of XRT's sword tanks there against another. I think that was Piggies who might have been responsible for it. As once again, they're just trying to find their way forward. Once again, Glop just resetting. Sword tanks to counter, but it's just not going to plan at the moment. M37, that is Meza Martin, just goes stratospheric as he gets smacked away by one of Girls Love Our Place tanks. Once again, it's a two-tank push, trying to forward more of a pitchfork than a trident at this point with only three players. But once again, the players bounce back. Running gets bounced back pretty far as well. This once again is still Girls Love Our Place have the balls. They're just trying to set up a very, very slow start compared to the first round, where this time they seem to have got their hammer rangers down. They know what they're up to, and they're just trying to find the way forwards, because if Girls Love Our Place lose by five rounds of this one, that is it. It is game over. The championship, the first ever Xbox One GGL championship, goes to XRT. But once again, it is Girls Love Our Place to have the ball. They've got a nice four-tank push coming up from our friends from Xbox. Record that. They're just trying to find their way forward. But it's just not going to plan. There's the pass. Is it going to work? There's no runner there. So it's going to be a dribble straight across. And it's Xbox Record that picks it up. And it's Meza Martin who has the ball. Three-tank push forming up at the moment. Now just down to two. And who's out in the front? We have ZF. That is Queen of the Sea. Big, big surprise in the AGLA possibly this season, going up to the Pro Leagues. And Sav on the far end. As we lost, I think that was Shadow who just got smacked. No, it wasn't Shadow, my mistake. That was Infinite Rain who got wiped out. So they're just trying to sneak around and find their way forwards. But it's Smackdown once again. They're just trying to sneak in. Runners exposed, but they got tanks just coming in. Queen of the Sea's going to be there, but it gets taken out. So there's still an enemy tank still behind. The runners exposed once more. They're still trying to get the advancement. But is the delay going to be costly? Because there's still tanks coming in from behind. It's going to get the bounce up, not the stiff arm. But somehow we have Reds just managed to get there in time to spare any further damage as the ball is thrown back. So we picked once again by Meza Martin as they're just trying to reset, respawn, and restart. So it's very much an even play at the moment, Goose. It's difficult to see who's really out on top. Despite Girls Love Our Place dictating the possession for the first part now, it seems to be a lot more advancement or a lot more rapid movement has come from Xbox Record that in this first round.
Well, I know they do things differently across the pond receptor, so maybe it's a reflection thing, but Girls Love Our Place is actually red.
Oh dear. I was thinking this something didn't match
it's
up.
Not, it's not your
from
fault.
The last one.
They switched on us in the lobby, so it's not you, it's them. But so yes, everything you just said, I would agree with the opposite of it.
Indeed. So now that we've returned from Wonderland and looking out the mirrors, it's amazing what happens when you have an Atlantic connection. Once again, so it's Girls Love Our Plays who has the ball. Just coming underneath this, Meza Martin once again has the ball. He got two Xbox Record that tanks dealing in. Is he going to get sliced? No, it's a mutual in the end. The ball is dropped. dribbles across the floor with fireworks everywhere. It's gone across the other side of the court. Is he picked up by Xbox to call that? But Savasaurus Rex says not happening. He takes down Shadow S16. As he now has the ball, I believe, and he's just waiting for his tanks to help out. Once again exposed. It is all over the place. Just pressure all around from Xbox Recall. The ball is just bouncing this way, that way, all across. It's picked up by about two different colours. It's practically purple with the amount of red and blue possession it's getting. As it's just being rolled across now, it's going to be left open once again. So a bit more scrappy play now. So he could see a chance of more of a mistake leading to the first goal and maybe opening up the floodgates, because it does seem to happen sometimes where the first couple of rounds do tend to be slow, but then momentum picks up. Once again, it is currently Xbox Record that who have the ball, as they got the one tank leading and right at the front. Trident just forming up, but one tank's taken out. It seems that the first lead tank got exposed, got taken out, and has left it all alone as the ball is now cross-court past. And he's to be picked up by, I believe that was Mankennon, was it, who has it? And he's picked up, and that's going to be Shadow's King who has the ball. Two tanks leading, down to one. One underneath as well, but once again, Girls Love a Play just causing all pressure as they're just moving across. The ball is somehow kept distance away from them. Almost trying to do a bit of a launch in the back there. I don't know whether that was intentional or was that just a missed swing from Xbox Record. The ball's passed across once again. A bit of a Harlem Globetrot was going on here. Just a reminder as well for anyone watching, and they've not seen one of these games before, there is no auto pickup in a GGL match. So when you see the people making these catches, they're holding down the catch button. But there it is, goal! Digital Pain just opens up the gates. Three red X's, four red X's. So all of Girls Love Our Place wiped out to lead to that. So that is it. First goal, and the floodgates open. Going to Xbox Record that.
So I know when we started the round, we didn't even mention the roster changes. So there's been a big roster change for XRT. Shadows on the court, but everybody else has rotated out. Now there's Piggies and Mancannon and Digital Pain. So they've traded out three of their players from the game they just won. So we'll see how they do going forward. There were no changes that I could tell on Girls Love Our Plays. So it's as if XRT actually has two teams that they're subbing in and out. I would love to know, in their opinion, like to pull each member of XRT aside and ask them who's on varsity and who's on JV. But, we'll wait till after the season before we start team drama.
Indeed, as the ball is arced high across the sky, dribbles across as we picked up by Meza Martin once again for Girls Love Plays. He's got one sword tank to deal with. Gets taken out. I think that was the Piggies who was trying to get it in, but a very, very tight push coming in from Girls Love Our Plays at the moment. It's not very much a spread out method we've seen from Xbox Record. That is very much more very, very tightly packed, just getting three hammers swinging down at once, but it doesn't seem to be come to fruition. But good defense coming in from Girls Love Our Place. An amazing sword lunge. I think that was Meza Martin who got the sword lunge. It was Meza Martin who got it. I don't know how he pulled it off, but the ball is still held at the moment. Still getting some pressure coming in, and it's turned over going to Xbox Record that.
The XRT holding steady, looking for some time with the ball, and this is what kind of happened last game too, is that time of possession was definitely in favor of Girls Love Our Place. Oh, is XRT, can he stick the landing?
Yes, he does.
Yes, he can.
Key tanking down the bottom as well to clear the plant to allow him to drop in, because you can see he was just waiting for that clearance, I think, from the Piggies to ensure that he could get down and not deal with any bouncing, and he just went, thank you very much. Boom, there goes the second goal. So 2-0 to Xbox Record that.
Actually reminds me of one of the Grifball highlight reels that we had where there was somebody on the plant and just decided to do a double wall hop jump on top of the plant. Ended up everybody on the defensive team murdering each other because they were trying to swing in anticipation of the runner, and then the runner just, you know, tiptoed through the tulips and brought that point on home. So I would not be surprised to see if we see more fun, action-y, launchy stuff, because with people like Piggies and Man Cannon on the court, You're gonna see it, and there, oh my goodness.
Oh, bounce, 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 straight up into the air. Somehow goes into the stratosphere in the process, but up he goes, straight back down, somehow survives. That's Meza Martin, who's managed to defy death once again. As he gets the stiff arm, bounces up once again. He's got another hammer tank underneath. I'm surprised that nobody from XRT pulled out a sword. Now they pull it out, but it ends up being a mutual against Sapasaurus Rex. As once again, it's still Girls Love Our Plays, holding the ball steady and for red team. Just trying to find their way forward. One, two, three tanks all forming up. They've down to two, but they're still two against two, so there's a high chance we could see a good movement going on here. But no, it is XRT neutralizes the play, and now it's a respawn and reset and restart from And girls love our plays. They're just going to run as exposed once again. It's going to have to be a cross-court pass. It's going to be a good pass as well, actually. Going up ahead of play, so it allows them to keep sprinting forwards. And it allows them to completely turn the momentum towards it. As the ball is still there, runner's on his own. Is he going to try and go for one stiff arm? He does.
Oh, yeah.
The goal is open, and there's the goal. No! My goodness, what a clutch play to deny. Inches from the pad. Whoever got that sword lunge, that was absolutely outstanding. As the ball now goes cross-court pass. Dribbles across, but there's no one there to pick it up, so it's going to be passed straight back to Girls Love Our Place as they now reset and hopefully try and get that one little toe closer so they can get that score, because that was, I don't know how on earth that did not go in. Whoever managed to defend that, props to them, that was impressive.
Well, especially considering you could see how XRT was spreading their forces. They kept one person with eyes on the runner, but their defensive tanks were going after the Glock tanks, which is not a bad thing. Oh, we've got Stab here on the plant. And there you go.
And it's boom.
Yeah, that after being denied that other goal just about 30 seconds ago, I feel like that's kind of karma. I feel like they deserve that goal. And then, of course, Martin making that a reality.
Not you do so. It's not over yet, folks. We're only three rounds in, still six to go. And it's going to be very close to see what's going to happen next now. And how is this going to play? Now they've got the confidence. They know they can score against each other once again. How is this going to start? Starting with the tip-off. And it's an absolute bloodbath. And the ball's been left behind. Oh, dear. That was Queen of the Sea who picks up the ball for Girls Love Our Plays there. Everyone just advanced forwards, hoping someone else picked it up. They thought it was still behind him. But in the end, that completely stalled the momentum as well from Girls Love Our Plays. And they've had to restart it. And unfortunately, that means Xbox report that tanks have all spawned up and are there to defend. So it's very much gone back to square one in terms of neutrality. As once again, it's forming up that three-tank push, trying to loop around, but it's just iron defense, then iron blue, a blue cobalt wall coming in from Xbox to call that. As the ball is caught mid-air by Saposaurus Rex, he's already got one tank to contend with, but he's already got someone there to protect him as well. That is a three, let's see if I get this right, 365 infinite rain, but the, still, once again, the Xbox record that tanks are just causing problems, and it's all pressure now onto the panda, the respawn zone. Better watch that sword behind you. Almost gets the mid-air lunge, but jumps away. But it's going to be passed back, and it's going to be almost an interception as it's now picked up once again by Meza Martin. He's got a bit of an opening, but all four of Xbox record that tanks have respawned, and they're just going to form up an iron line and say, yeah, you're not getting past here, buddy boy. As once again, they're just trying to sneak in, hopefully trying to find an opening, either through flanking or just getting a huge tank push in. Not seeing much in terms of launches, more of an Xbox record that kind of play of expectancy from Mankind and Piggies. But once again, they're going to have to think of another way forward at the moment, because there's the drop, and it's picked up by, I think it was Digital Pain who got the kill, and I think it's Shadow who has the ball.
Yeah, it was also Shadow who got that clutch stop in the last round before Girls Love Our Plays just kind of came around and scored again anyway. So Shadow beasting it up. Sab, there's some comments in the chat box about the wall of Sab. He's putting up. So XRT, that was something we saw last game, something we've seen several times already in this game, is the defensive stylings of XRT and their ability to come up big in clutch moments on the plant at the very last possible second. And right now they've got the ball and are on their own spawn line. Martin pressuring in, the runner being forced to this near corner. Here comes Infinite Rain, but he gets just kind of checked out at the very end. Runner gets some room to run. And XRT now, you know, again, not having the bulk of the possession, but the runner doing a lot of good work. You'll see him tack up and then tack back. Again, that's to kind of draw the tanks away as much as you can. And if a tank is looking at you, then they're maybe not looking at one of your tanks behind them. Maybe they missed it on the radar. And so the runner, part distraction, part tank, part passing phenom, because there they go. A rather dangerous ball right to the center, but XRT just makes it look effortless. Both these teams make it look so incredibly easy.
Digital Pain certainly being the defensive powerhouse or offensive powerhouse for Xbox to call that at the moment. Just seeing again doubles and triples against the Girls Love Our Plays tanks. So it's very much, he seems to be a key player at the moment, despite Shadow having the highest points, mostly down to goals. He seems to be the one more offensive, just trying to find those openings whilst Cannon and Piggies try to sneak around both sides. But something I haven't actually seen from Man Cannon thus far is he is infamous for sneaking around the sides and then causing problems on the plant. But now Xbox recalled that. Astana advanced forwards. It's completely all around. Are they going to try and get a pass? No, he backs in. He gets bounced up. And there's the smackdown. The ball just bounces off the wall in front of my face in the commentary booth. And it's going to be picked up by Xbox recalled that once again. So sweet mercies for the Blues. As somehow the bounce up from, I think it was Shadow got bounced up, is denied. And once again, it's still Xbox recalled that have the ball. They got to find another way forwards. They got two tanks advancing in. Now just down to the one. It's all alone as the ball is now passed up. But it's in an completely clear area. Infinite Rain is there to counter, but he gets taken out and it's going to be picked up once again. So it's currently Xbox Record that who have the ball as they're now resetting, but already Girls of Our Plays are just causing pressure into the spawn zone. We got Infinite Rain, Queen of the Sea and Sav already causing problems, but they're all taken out. Three red X's across the board as they're just trying to once again respawn and just form up that iron wall as we saw with Xbox Record. But it's just not going to plan as the three tank push is coming in from Xbox Record. That this could be it. They're still there. Is he going to get the pass? No, the runner gets taken out. The runner was smacked down and once again he's picked up by Meza Martin. Now here comes the counter attack from Girls Love Our Plays. How are they going to play? Is he going to run straight in? No, he's got a dance in one sword runner. He gets the stiff arm and that was against the man cannon who he's countering with. But Girls Love Our Plays still have the ball, still trying to advance forwards, but they're not even getting out of their end of the court to them, and such as the defense from Xbox recall that they had a good chance for a good counter attack, but it just couldn't get the momentum or the movement in time with a couple of sword tanks causing issues. But once again the runner's playing a little bit more conservatively, always on his own. Three red X's across the board once again for lead tank, so the runner's exposed. Now they've got to respawn and reset, but a bit of a bounce across for the sword tank that could be decisive if he finds a way around. But he decides to bring out the hammer instead for Xbox recall that, as once again now here comes the advancement. Sabasaurus Rex clearing house and getting the Mesomata straight in for two all.
Yeah, so Martin, I think he's MVP of that round, if I'm going to call that. He's the one who came up with the epic stop and obviously just drove home the equalizing goal. So it's two all right now. And I mean, again, it's important to keep in mind that Girls Love Our Plays, they were warmed up. They played the same roster last game. XRT has three cold players coming in. And
Roran.
Wow.
So, and that is how you respond.
He just says, shut up, Goose. I don't need to be warm. I can fly when I want to.
Pigs can fly.
Yeah, pigs can fly and geese can not commentate. So, well, that is what Xbox Record That thinks of that. So...
The big thing was there is when Piggy's managed to go airborne, she got a second boost off one of the Girls Love Our Place tanks, which led her to get the momentum to land onto the core, on straight into the plant. So had she not had that hammer swing, there was a chance she could have been lunged. Whereas Girls Love Our Place out of the ball, the ball's still been left loose. It's going to be Sam who's going to pick it up now, as they're just trying to sneak it around once again. Maybe find a way forward, but he's got two sword tanks to contend with immediately, so he's just going to throw it straight out, straight into the hands of Meza Martin. He takes that ball in his hands, gets some good grips on it. He's going to advance straight forwards with Sabasaurus Rex and 365, which is Infinite Rain. But he's already got problems. There's already tanks. Xbox recall that tanks from all different angles as the ball is dropped. I can't see where it's landed, though. No, it's picked up once again. It's Sabasaurus Rex that has the ball, so somehow it's been passed across. Takes it straight back to Meza Martin as a hammer somehow just smacks against the wall from a bit of Franklin going on as the ball is... Oh, my goodness. This is bad. Oh, a massive slice. Who is that? I got the slice. I think it was Shadow. And it's going to be opening straight in. The runner thinks better of it. Is he going to pass it straight back? No, he's going to run back and wait for his tanks to come in. Bit of an air attack. That does not work. Shadow tried to go for the matchmaking tanking option. And it just didn't go to plan. Sabasaurus Rex just laughs as he swings his hammer down to it. As Xbox recall that somehow recovered the ball from Glop's side of the court. So that kind of sums up the play. If Glop don't get any more advances, despite the goals being 3-2 at this point, there's still a couple of problems going on for Girls Love Our Plays. They need to get a bit more cohesive and ensure they keep possession, especially there in the court, because they can't allow mistakes like that. As Xbox recall that still have the ball, as they're just trying to sneak in 1, 2, 3, 4 tanks, still just trying to get forwards. All the defense going in, but it's still Xbox recall that with the ball, trying to sneak in, but it's just not going to plan at the moment. They're just trying to find an advancement or even surprise, maybe try a surprise launch, as they're just trying to sneak in, but Girls Love Our Plays certainly getting that defense going. But now here's the opening. They've managed to get three tanks in already into the spawn zones. This could be problems if they can get the timing just right. But some are still clearing house. There's still one Xbox record that tank on the plant. Who's going to notice it? It's going to be Infinite Rain who takes out Shadow, who's just sitting there on the respawn zones. But once again, Xbox record that relentlessly respawning and already advancing, causing problems already deep into Glop's own half. As they're just trying to sneak in, there's still one tank left. Who's going to take Infinite Rain? Is going to try and clear house once again for the one causing problems. Does so. And that's Man Cannon trying his typical techniques. But once again, Exports are called. I still have the ball despite the defense being pulled by Glop. Now they finally get it. The ball goes arcs across. It goes to the back left corner as the ball is picked up by Xbox Record that once again. So somehow, despite taking out the runner, Glop just can't win it as Xbox Record have somehow managed to pick it up. But that was the first time we've really seen them take out the runner in that last 10 minute of play. Just trying to find the way forward, trying to sneak it in, but here's the chance again. The ball is dropped. Not sure where it's been dropped though. It's going to be picked up by, I think it's Piggies who might have the ball. No, my mistake, it's not Piggies. That is... I believe that might be...
That was Digital.
Digital Pain who had it. Yeah, it was Digital Pain who had the ball. It's now picked up, and now it's going to be picked up by the standard runner. Bit of a butterfingers going on there as the ball is picked up. Finally, and there's two tanks coming in. Almost, Infinite Raid nearly takes out the runner. Shadow somehow just gets there in time and denies. But it's already problems going in. Just hear a sword being swung there somewhere nearby as there's still Wayne just trying to get that sneak advance, but Xbox Record again, lots of chance of sneaking in. There's a cross court pass, runners going straight in. This is going to be somehow they missed the pass was slightly off, which allowed Girls Love Our Place to get there and form up the defense. But if that had been a more accurate pass, that could have been game over and curtains for a 4-2 lead, as it was just nobody contending the runner. The runner goes on his own once again. One man army just parts the seas. Digital Pain just parts the Red Sea and goes in, and we're assassinated by someone in blue. Not sure what that was all about. But my goodness, he puts out his hand, just pushes them aside and gets it in. So yeah, that's a 4-2 lead to Xbox Record that. Yeah, one more goal is all they need.
Digital doesn't believe apparently in hammers or physics, because he's just like, I'm going to do what I want to do, so there. And I do what I want. And he did.
That he did. And it's once again, Xbox Record that win it. And at this point, Girls Love Our Place cannot afford to make a single mistake. Any betrayal, any mistake, any mistimed lunge will cost them the championship, because it is one goal in it to get the victory. So it's going to be interesting to see how it's going to play. Are they going to just go all out for the runner? Or are they just going to form basically a phalanx wall against there? And you can see they're very, very tightly packed once again, opening up the chance for betrayals or even double kills from Xbox Record that. Now they're spreading out, trying to expose that runner, but once again, it's very difficult for Girls Love Our Place to get to that runner. That runner's got a very good buffer zone with the tanks. Now here's the chance. Is it going to throw straight? There's still one tank straight there already from Xbox Record that. Now the runner's exposed. It's passed straight across, but it's going to be picked up once again. This is the issue at the moment for Girls Love Our Place. They can't get anywhere near the runner. They can't get there to dictate the play. And once again, there's the example. Shadow S16 taking out Mez and Martin, who tried to get a sword in. There's the chance again, but the ball is now passed across. So is it going to have to be Girls Love Our Place? They're going to have to pressurize Xbox Record to make a bad pass or have a runner or player ready to intercept or dispute for the ball, because it's just not getting there in time and it's just causing problems because they're just keeping possession straight up for Xbox Record that. But once again, still two tanks leading in, just going straight in. There's 1, 2, 3, 4 tanks for Girls Love Our Place, just trying to form it up and just trying to sneak in, but it's just not happening. It's very much that slow kind of play once again, just trying to find that opening or just waiting for Digital to have his magic moments. Finally, Sab takes out the runner, does not pick up the ball, and now he does. So that could have been a costly mistake, but now's the chance for Girls Love Our Place to make their own chance and bring the goals back to them.
So we've got a lot of people in the chat box, so if you're just joining us, welcome. This is game 2 of the series. Xbox Record that is up in the series, and one more goal and they will actually take the championship. So Girls Love Our Place, who currently have the ball there in red, and they've got a large hole to dig themselves out of, and turning the ball over to Shadow like that is not going to help their case. But as the game is, it's still on the line, it's still possible. Grifball, we play 9 rounds, so you know, I've seen stranger things happen. That was a narrow miss by Girls Love Our Plays. Both teams have been playing just absolutely spectacularly. XRT has been dominant though, despite the KD spreads we saw last match.
Oh dear.
No. Again, playing a little bit more conservatively. That must not be Digital, because Digital would have just decided, I'm going for it, Leroy Digital Pain. And so we'll see how it turns out. But I just want to remind everybody that if you enjoy your Grifball action, be sure to hit that little heart button at the bottom of your viewing screen that subscribes you to the channel, and it lets us know that you heart us, because we totally heart you in every sense of that word. Here comes
the opening and victory. They had a nice big tank run forming up, and that led to it. And there's the obligatory slunges from Pinhead Larry, who's watching with us in the commentary booth. But yeah, that's it. Victory Championship for the first ever Xbox One GGL Winter League 2015 goes to Xbox. Record that.
So well done. Congrats to XRT. I'm pretty sure in the previous Hubcast we had them going to the championship. They were definitely favored to win. Again, when you have a roster like that, it is it's
a powerhouse.
Stupid. It's stupid to vote against them. But Girls Love Our Place, obviously a great team. They got to the runner up, and if XRT cannot execute their duties as champions, then you know, not that that's ever happened, but. Great game to Girls Love Our Plays. They put up some great stats. They had some really great shotgun launches and plants of their own. They got themselves a pro run, which is no easy feat against a team like XRT. And it's a really exciting way to close out the GGL season. And with that glitching red bar, at least it waited.
Oh my!
At least it waited. Yeah. All I can say.
That is a Grifball game with manners, but. Yeah, for everything that Girls Love Plays done, they showed they have ability also to beat whatever, who cares, Melvin's team. That took some abilities, but there's the slice. The goal is open. Thinks better of it. That delay could be costly. Instead goes for the stiff arm, but he's already got two tanks to contend with, and there it is, Infinite Ray. Somehow, once again, the ball is picked up by Xbox. Recall that they just seem to get there and rest the ball, deny any chance possession. That has been the story for this game. For Girls Love Plays, they have not been able to get the ball and dictate the game. As it's always been, the ball has just been passed back, scooped up, picked up, recovered by Xbox Record that. But once again, they've managed to get the ball despite defusing that counterattack from Girls Love Our Plays. And it is the story of what we've seen. And there's the line. Oh my goodness, almost gets there. That was a fantastic launch, but he threw the ball down. If they held the ball on, that could have been a goal. But once again, it's a good attempt. Now it's a little bit more fun going on. That was a shotgun launch we saw. As it's Xbox Record that I still have it. As they're just trying to get it. There's another bounce trying to go for a matchmaking. Getting to the stiff arm does not work. Queen of the Sea says, no, I will have that. Impales the runner with the horn on top of her head. As now she advances on and hopefully tries to get a goal just for pride for Girls Love Our Plays.
So, Receptor, we're getting some feedback from the chat box that we don't sound excited enough about a championship win. So I think I need to maybe, you know, kind of rewind and maybe... Perfect Demise apparently wants some more dramatics. So, Receptor, would you mind going kind of taking it to the next level and going over the top?
Right then. Well, this should be interesting at 3:53 in the morning, so I will do the best I can. But there it is, ladies and gentlemen. Xbox Record That. Take the victory for the first ever Xbox One GGL Championship in Winter League 2015 as they get it by... It is 5-2 in the end as they get a two-game series, winning 5-4 in the previous one, I believe. And that is it. So well done to the blue and red as they were. So it's all purple victory for Xbox. Record that.
Okay. Asking for more excitement. I don't know what more we can do. I feel like my level of excitement is Shadow wins another ship.
Yeah, it seems to be a repetitive thing. It's a safe bet, but is this going to be a goal for pride now? Against the stiff arm, the opening's there, and yes, yeah. It is. So there we have it. A little bit more pride coming through now for Girls Love Our Plays and the obligatory assassination. But yes, I'll try and be more excited for Wednesday. I promise you that, because I am home alone and I will not be waking up anyone. So yeah, if you want to see more excitement, tune in on Wednesday at 8:30. Is it 8:30 or 9:30, Goose?
8:30 Eastern.
Yeah, so tune in at 8:30 Eastern for the start of the AGLA Pro season, and then you'll see plenty more excitement coming from me, so tune in then.
Yep.
As once again, it is Girls Love Our Plays that have the ball. Mind the swings there, Pinhead, as he gets in. But it's the runner still bounced up. There's the chance, and straight in. Queen of the Sea gets on the run, and it's game over. 5-4. So game that concludes man. The GGL.
All right, let me muster the energy. Congratulations, Xbox Record That! You just won the GGL Xbox One Winter Division! What are you gonna do next? Congratulations! There you go.
Indeed, I think what they're gonna do next is, Shadow gets another year with Maria. That's good news, because she promises, I think it's every month or every year for every trophy he wins.
A year for every ship.
a year for every ship, so now they can expand it to 19 years of happiness. So soon, they will get to the next level of the wedding anniversary. So good news for them. But welcome Solace just in time. But it was a whole victory for Xbox Record. They won Game 1 and Game 2. So let's break down the stats.
All right, so XRT won all the games. Digital Pain won 1890, Shadow 1740, Piggies 1560, Man Cannon 1160, Martin 1710, Sab 1690, Infinite Rain 1590, and Queen of the Sea at 1530. The gold a little bit more spread out this time. Digital with 3, Shadow and Piggies each with 1, and Martin had 2 for his team. Sab also had a point. Some defensive stops, not a whole lot, and there were 2 interceptions, 1 by Piggies and 1 by Shadow. The game is 26 minutes long, so about 10 minutes, maybe about 6 minutes shorter than the last match, although I felt like it went by a lot faster. Digital, of course, went positive. He went positive 12, Shadow negative 14, Piggies net positive 10, I'm sorry, Man Cannon negative 6, Martin plus 1, Sab plus 3, Infinite Rain minus 9, and Queen of the Sea negative 23. So, a little bit different on the KD side of things for XRT. It's interesting that you could argue that maybe this was their stronger tanking lineup as opposed to the first team, but I think both teams played excellently for XRT, and of course, huge shout out to Girls Love Our Plays. Great series, and was a pleasure absolutely to commentate and to stream this match. And, Receptor, did you want to look at the medals at all? Or I'm not sure.
I do indeed, because I'm just having a look-see at Piggy's medals. And she managed to get off a Kilimanjaro somewhere in there, along with 4 killing sprees. That's just the tanking prowess we were seeing from Piggy's in there. I didn't really mention much. She seemed to slip under the radar for me. But 2 Kiltrocities as well, along with 4 overkills. So very much lots of kills going on then. Hopping across over to Shadow, who's very much the runner, and he managed to get a couple of goalkeepers, so very much those clutch plays, including that massive defense against Girls Love Our Plays in the second or third round. So very much straight in, then hopping across over to Digital Pain, the man who led many of those attacks. He managed to get 3 killing sprees in the process, and also managed to get a couple of goalkeepers as well, so he was also there on the defense, and apparently we're going into Skyward.
Yeah, Cal, do the thing where you do the thing. But yeah, good game to both teams, and I want a huge shout-out to Pinhead Larry for neutral hosting the match. Neutral hosts don't ever get enough love, so here is your love. We are giving it to you. And, of course, huge shout-out to everybody in the chat box. At one point, we were over 50 people, so that's really exciting. Thank you all for coming out, supporting these teams. I know they appreciate it. We appreciate it. And, of course, if you want more Grifball action, be sure to check out GrifballHub.com. That's the mothership. Everything you could possibly ever want about Grifball is there. You can also find us on Twitter, at Grifball and at GrifballHub, if you prefer shorter communications. We're also on Facebook. And, so subscribe to us here on Twitch. That helps our numbers. It helps us out a lot. So thank you, Receptor, for commenting, and happy birthday.
Well, thank you very much. I had to think, 24, what do I do next?
Oh, stop. Just stop. don't complain. I have no sympathy here.
It's going to be amazing. But now it's going to be pancake birthday cakes in 6 hours, because it is Mardi Gras over in America, but over in the UK, it is Shrove Tuesday, also known as Pancake Day. So yes, I'm going to have a pile of pancakes with a candle on top with maple syrup tomorrow morning.
That sounds awesome. I'm going to make sure that we have pancakes, too, to celebrate in solidarity.
I agree. So thank you very much for letting me on. I will catch everyone on Wednesday, hopefully, if you could join us for the start of the AGLA Pro Big League season. It's going to be a fantastic series of games. Shadow will be back again for that. I think he's in the opening match. So Shadow never seems to get away from the limelight or the live stream court. So we will see him again soon. And thank you to Raider for wishing me happy birthday.
Yeah. All right. So again, tune in Wednesday. We've got Shadow versus Silva for your first match. Just the two of them, you know, punching each other in the face.
That is a grudge match and a half. We are in for one heck of a game.
And then we also have a rematch from last season's champions of Next Dimension versus Pro Red. So it's going to be a lot of fun. Receptor will be commentating for you. He'll take good care of you. But until then, on behalf of everybody here at Grifball Hub and all the Grifballers everywhere, hammer on, my friends. Good stuff. And of course, everybody in the chat box, you rock, you're awesome. We love you, heart long time.
Get hammered.
Woo! But responsibly. All right, bye.
Responsibly always.